back. After 3 years, you wasn't releasing anything. What makes you stop for 3 years? What makes you reflect on what you was doing?
Right. I had little setbacks with Eric B. Man, Eric B. had a problem, and it took like a year and a half for me to get a new contract. And then once I got my new contract, I was working on an album, and then MCA fired their staff, and whoever had access to the tapes that I had, the demos I was working on. They sold them to mixtapes and radio stations like New York to Cali, Rhyme Till It's Time to Go, you know what I mean? I changed that, put it on the album, but it was a lot of joints that I did. Yeah, I get visual, you know what I mean? It's a lot of joints that I did, and I had to scratch all that, you know what I mean? So that took time. But now I'm on Universal, and everything is smooth, man, you know what I mean? And it just feel good to be back, man. Hold up.
McQuaid is the drawing up the Paisley form. Micah stay warm, my flow is Davey on.
You're deep into your belief, right, being a 5%er. How do this influence your writing?
Well, a whole much, man, because what I study, you know what I mean, and I feel life is the foundation, you know what I mean? So when I'm studying life, I feel I got a good understanding enough where I can deal in equality and pass it on to whoever want it, you know what I mean? So, right now, that's my foundation. If it wasn't for Islam, I'd probably be still hanging out, doing the wrong things in the street. You know what I mean? No responsibilities, man. But I got Islam that holds me down, teach me how to take care of my family, to teach me how to be conscious. You know what I mean?
How do you feel about other people riding like more into a gangster way and doing things in like solving problems in a different way?
A wise man don't knock nobody for what they do or what they believe in, you know what I mean? But I feel with hip hop, we gotta it's good to let people know that we living in hell, you know what I mean? And things of that nature, and little jewels that we drop to try to help people to get out of hell. But at the same time, we gotta remember this is hip hop, and we gotta bring skills to the table and keep hip hop strong, man.
Okay, we all know that hip hop is made out of four elements, right? And I know in your early day, you was already talking about writing graffitis on the wall, breakdancing and all that. Now today is like most of people think it's coming back to fashion. How do you feel about these four elements and how much they count for you?
As far as fashion and hip hop right now, well, fashion been a big statement in hip hop from day one because hip hop it's a culture, it's an expression. Know what I mean, the way we wear our jeans, the way we walk, the way we talk. Know what I mean, but at the same time, the clothes is not what make you a hip hop head. Know what I mean, come from the inside. Know what I mean, it's like my man today, he danced on stage while I was doing my thing. He was breakdancing. It's not what he wore down here that made him look good while he was breakdancing. It's what he was doing, you know what I mean, while he was breakdancing. So what we got to understand, it's not the shell. It's the inside. Hip-hop come from the inside, and we all play a part. If it's just the B-boy standing way in the back of the club, leaning on the wall, not making a move, he plays a part in hip-hop, you know what I mean? If it's the one that's in the middle of the crowd just going wild, just like, you know what I mean? Everybody got an important hip-hop, important position to play in hip-hop. And once we all realize that, we'll know that we all important and just keep it alive. Bro.
You say we gotta go back to B-boy breakdancing.
No doubt.
That's what you mean.
You know what I mean? And you know what I'm saying? I was speaking on, you know what I mean? The real elements of hip hop. You know what I mean? I mentioned we use walls and subway trains for marquees. You know what I mean? All we needed was somewhere to get our name up. You know what I mean? All we needed was 5 or 3 feet, a little box to break dance on. All we needed was something, man. And that's what it's all about. It ain't gotta be a 20-foot stage. All we need is a low spot and a couple of minutes to shine, man. Hold up.
Okay, before you left, Eric B, he was taking care of the production, right? Now,
Eric was doing some of the production. A lot of beats on the old albums I did, you know what I mean? He did the cutting, and everybody thought the DJ made the beats and the MC rhyme, but I did a lot of the beats on the first album, but Eric B, you know what I'm saying, he held me down, no doubt.
Large Professor, he was the one that did it, Eric B's president.
Oh, nah, Eric B is president. I bought the beat, I bought the James Brown beat and the Over Like a Fat Rat bass line, know what I mean? And Marley, we took it to Marley crib and Marley played it over and he looped up the beat for us, you know what I mean? But Lars Professor, he came like Sweat the Technique album, know what I mean? Yeah, and a couple of joints on the album previous to that. But that's my man too, you know what I mean? Lars Professor was blazing, know what I mean? He used to always hit me with beats, know what I'm saying? I got love for him too, man. Hold up. Like when I write, I try to write from everybody's point of view, know what I mean? I call it universal thoughts, meaning if I'm experiencing something or if I know something is happening that I know everybody deal with, that's what I write about. So people can understand it and relate with what I'm talking about, you know what I mean? So I always try to just be universal, man. And word up, you know what I mean? Word up, man. And we do need a lot more rappers with more messages, man, because, you know what I'm saying, that was hip-hop, man. Somebody, you know, they came down with something, man, something for the listener, something to grasp the listener and make them say, oh, even when they go home, they be walking up the street later on, and then, oh, you know what that kid said? He said, blahzy, blah, boom, you know what I mean? Like, it'll hit them later, and that's what the wittiness was all about, so we got to bring that back to the table.
Okay, Rakim, listen, it's been a pleasure to have you on the show, and I hope to see you back in Italy, not in the next 10 years, but maybe the next one or two.
No doubt, you know what I mean? If it's the end of this summer, I'll be back. If it's next summer, I'll be here, man, because it's definitely like what I'm doing, I'm on tour right now, and what I'm learning is hip-hop is universal, man, and we taking the world by storm, so... If Italy give me the welcome mat, I'll be back, baby. What's going on? Guess who's back, baby? Rockin' my law, you know what I'm saying? And right now, what we about to do is boogie down. So that's where we at, you know what I'm saying? So, yo, pump up your values and play it loud, baby. Peace. Boogie down. Yeah. 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 Yeah.